Welcome everybody here for this episode of Chop Talk with head coach Shawn Garus. Coach, coming off of the Boise State Classic, hosted some quality opposition this week. Why don't you talk about the tournament overall?
Yeah, I thought it was a lot of fun. The first match that we played was against number one in the country, Minnesota, and I couldn't be prouder of how the team battled. I think we came out with good confidence in the first set, played some great volleyball, lots of long rallies. We ended up losing the set by a couple of points, but I really liked the team's energy. When we switched sides, there was this vibe that we weren't settling. We weren't happy to be close, that you know they knew they had a chance to beat that team. The second set was very similar. We played good volleyball. Minnesota was just a little bit better. We go into the break between 2 and 3. We had 10 minutes to talk and think about what we wanted to do and what the matchup was like. Made a couple of adjustments, and I think the team came out and played their best volleyball in sets 3 and 4 to push it to a fifth set. So really proud of the character of our team to be challenged like that against number one in the country, to be down 2 sets 0 and come back even stronger and push it to a fifth set. And it was 7-all in the fifth set. I mean, anybody's game. Both teams were playing well at that time. And in the end, they just had a little too much. We had a little bit of trouble stopping them at the net. If we didn't get them out of system, their setter is so good and their offense was so sharp that we couldn't hang in the end, and we ended up losing 15-12 in the fifth. But that match was big for a lot of different reasons. One, it proved to our team that we can play at a high level for a sustained amount of time. But also, the crowd was unbelievable. We had a student section as large as I've ever seen for a home volleyball game. The gym was full before the match started. I know the game management said they had to turn away a lot of fans. So to see the volleyball community come out and support our effort was really cool. When we lost set one after a really long rally, it was a standing ovation for both teams' level of play. And things like that are just really, really good to see, and I'm very proud of what we've accomplished there. The next morning, we had a tough match against Oregon State. It was a very good team. They've had a great preseason, and we just didn't have the energy that we wanted. I think we were still a little affected by the emotional drain of losing the 5-setter against Minnesota the night before. So Oregon State was able to get the win over us, but we rebounded and got a win over Idaho State to close out the tournament, which is a really important match. And it's a it's an in-state team that we want to be able to beat, but also it's the match that leads us into conference play this week. So overall, really, really fun atmosphere in Bronco Gym. Really, really good weekend for our team, and we're excited for the Mountain West.
Sarah Nobley led you again this past week. She set the school career points record against Minnesota. Just talk about her performance overall.
Sierra was great. Every match she came to play, her energy level was really good. Not just the kills that she's putting up, but she's doing a good job blocking. Her serving is improving. Her defense has been solid. And she's one of the anchors that we have in serve receive. So Sierra had definitely another great weekend. The other person that really stands out to me is Janelle Wally. I thought Janelle Wally, I think she was named all tournament for the weekend, and she had great offensive numbers in all three matches, which is really a good thing to see. She hasn't been as sharp in previous weekends, but she was really good. We could count on her to score all throughout the weekend, and so that bodes well for us moving into conference play as well.
Against Idaho State, you were able to play some of your freshmen a little bit more than you had in the past. How important is that for your program heading into conference?
Yeah, I love it. I think those two freshmen were very deserving of playing. So Carrie Leek was able to get her first career start, and Kylie Lewis as well. So they were able to get some quality reps in front of a good crowd against a good team, and they held up just fine. So I think that's more confidence for them moving into this week and for the future of the season. And then it gave some people some much needed rest time as well. So for Celine and Sabrin, for them to not start their first matches this year, it helps them as well to just be more fresh and ready for the rigors of conference.
You went 7-5 in non-conference this year, probably arguably the hardest non-conference schedule we've had in probably 2 decades. Where is your team at as far as your goals heading into conference after such a non-conference schedule?
Yeah, that's a really good question and something that we have talked about this week. We're not where we want to be. 7-5 is not a comfortable place for this team to be, but we are learning how to play with a little bit more of a target on our chest. We did win the Mountain West last year, and I think there's been a lot of teams in preseason that have really come after us. And so we lost a couple of true road games at Arizona State, at UC Davis. Those aren't results that we're really particularly happy with. But as you said, we did play a really, really tough schedule. We had nationally ranked teams here. We played them tough. We just weren't able to get the wins. And there's nobody in our program that is patting ourselves on the back for coming close. We're trying to win those games, and We're not being very patient about that. We're getting upset when we don't win that. We're tired of the close, you know, the close second place. And so I think the team is highly motivated to do better in conference than we did in preseason. And hopefully that tough preseason schedule will have prepared us for that.
You start title defense of your Mountain West Championship from last year this week at home. Fresno State Thursday, San Diego State on Saturday. What are you expecting out of those two squads?
I think both those teams will be ready to go. Fresno looks good on video. They've got a lot of returning starters from last year. I think they're well coached. Our staffs know each other well, and we know this match is critical for both teams. And we've had a great rivalry with Fresno over the years. We expect nothing different. It'll be a hard-fought match on Thursday night. And then Saturday, we play San Diego State. San Diego State had a really good result last week on the road. They beat University of Denver. Which I think is a great win for our conference to beat a team that I think is a top 50 program. So it shows that San Diego State's got the talent and the ability to win on the road. So I expect it to be a really tough weekend. Both matches will be hard fought, and I think the team that plays best will win because both teams are all the teams are evenly matched.
One last highlight, Maddie Osborne will become the career digs leader in Boise State history this week. She needs 21. Your thoughts on your libero?
I'm so proud of what Maddie has accomplished. She has been amazing this year. She plays with such speed and passion. She sets the bar really high for all the kids on our team as far as how hard you can work to be successful out there. So I'm thrilled with everything that she's accomplished. She's done a great job on and off the court, and she's grown into quite a leader for us. And you know, just couldn't be happier, and I hope she's able to get that many digs on Thursday night because we're going to need them all against Fresno.
How important is it for Bronco Nation to keep showing up to your matches?
Yeah, I think it's massive. You know, we have a small gym that creates a great environment if it's full. And so if we get a full house in there, it can stress the other team, but it definitely energizes our team. And I hope we get that student section back that has done such a great job at staying engaged and keeping the whole fan base excited. And I think we're gaining new fans every time we play at home. And I love seeing that. So yeah, but hopefully we can have the gym packed for both those games this weekend.
You've been listening to Chalk Talk with head coach Shawn Garus. Thanks, coach.
Thank you, Doug.